Fort McLeod Council Chambers. A Southern Alberta family is calling for changes in the way that Youth and Child Service makes funding decisions for children with severe disabilities. Allison Pike, who has two boys with autism, says many families have to fight year after year to get the services their children need. Terry Boat has their story.
You want them all, guys?
Yeah.
Allison Pike says being a social worker has helped her to navigate a complex and at times very frustrating system, one that's used to diagnose, assess, and qualify children who may need special services because of disabilities. Pike's sons, 6-year-old Braden and 5-year-old Brad, both have autism, and she knows that getting the specialized services they need early in their lives is critical to their futures. But she says the way the system works right now, she's forced to fight every step of the way to get those services.
We have proof that the programs are working with what I have fought for over the last years. And as a parent, I feel I shouldn't have to go through this.
Under the current system used by Family Support for Children with Disabilities, families work with a number of professionals to develop a plan for their children. But an anonymous, multidisciplinary panel makes the final decision on what services and supports will be funded. The panel is not obligated to meet with the parents or discuss its recommendations, and it does not see the child.
We were trying to prove whether Braden had significant behaviors. I asked if I could show a videotaping. They said there was no way that we could show a videotape of Braden, even though it was only a short 2-minute clip. And the only thing that we could do was show a physical picture, which a physical picture doesn't demonstrate behavior.
Families always have to be consulted in all steps of the process to make it successful.
The Lethbridge Association for Community Living says it's heard similar concerns from many other families. The Pikes say it's hard enough raising two boys with autism. They don't believe families should have to spend countless hours fighting with the bureaucracy that's supposed to be looking after the needs of their children. Terry Vogt, CTV News, Lethbridge.
We have left messages with the supervisor for the Southwest Region of Family Support for Children with Disabilities. So far, though, no one has returned our calls. Fifth on Fifth Youth Services held its appreciation banquet over the